Now, I know you've heard the saying a million times, where there's smoke, there's fire. Well, today we're going to give that saying the Emazing Eric remix. Check this out. Where there's smoke, there's fire, but where there's fire, there's heat. Oh, there's heat, y'all. And that heat will come to us in the form of Heather the Heat Hardy as she makes her return to the MMA cage on February 16th against Ana the Hurricane Julaton. So y'all know we gotta talk about it. Can we talk about it? Well, okay, let's go. Emazing Eric Sports. Let's go, man.
Emazing Eric Sports. Sports and laughs. It's all love. Ow!
What is up, all my fellow combat sports heads? It's your boy Eric, and you are now tuned in live to another episode of the Emazing Eric Sports Show. And today we want to talk about a fan-friendly, action-packed fighter making her return to the octagon in what promises to be a good scrap. Oh, trust me, this will be a fight. This is a can't-miss fight if ever there was one. And as we go along in the video, trust me, I will explain to you exactly why I say that. Now, before we get started in today's video, I want to point you to some other programming here that we have on Emazing Eric Sports. And since we're talking about Heather Hardy, we might as well recommend to you one of our older videos about Heather Hardy. Here's the thumbnail to that video. That video is titled Heather Hardy Bloodbath Fight Reaction. That video was made right after Heather Hardy's last fight, where she suffered an exciting and very bloody loss to Christina Williams. Again, something else we will cover as this video goes on. I will place that video in the description box for you, so as soon as you're finished with this one, why don't you go by and check that one out too? But wait till you finish now. Finish this one up first. Now, let's get started with today's video. I want to start by giving a shout out to my man, CSH Combat Sports. I got on the coach's page this morning, and this is the first I heard of this news. I checked out coach's video. Go watch his video on that. So I said to myself, oh my God, one of my favorite fighters, Heather Hardy's back. So I jumped over to Heather's Instagram page, and I ran right into this post. We'll pull it up for you. This is Heather Hardy's official Instagram page. Again, you see the blue check, so you know it's real. And Heather says, here we go, y'all. The fight news everyone's been waiting on. Who you got? February 16th, Mohegan Sun, Heat versus Julaton. I got excited when I saw that post. The first thing that excited me about that post is Heather herself actually uses the word y'all. And y'all know I love people that use the word y'all. See how much I'm saying it? I'm saying it so much, I'm mixing myself up. Come on, E. But no, real talk, what I really got excited about is that Heather is already back. And I was hearing people say, I don't know if Heather's going to come back to MMA. She just might go back to boxing after that horrible loss she had to Christina Williams. And I said to them, if that's what you really think is going to happen, you don't know Heather. And that's a perfect segue. Those of you that know me know I love a good segue. We'll segue this right into what I was saying earlier when I said this is an action-packed fighter in a can't-miss fight. The very first reason I would give you as to why this is a can't-miss fight is because Heather Hardy's in it. She is truly what you would call a fan-friendly fighter. She brings it. She doesn't care if she's bleeding. She's a true blood and guts warrior. She usually bleeds in her fights, and she keeps coming forward. She keeps trying to make the action. Always a good scrap when you have Heather Hardy. And the other thing that makes this a great scrap is that she's fighting someone that she's been circling compared to since her boxing days. If we go back to the days when Heather and Ana were both just boxing, before they both started doing MMA, people were already talking about what would happen between them in a boxing ring. So I'm sure these two ladies have always been watching the other one, paying attention to the other one, being compared to each other. Whenever you get a situation like that and the two combatants finally get it on, they always bring a good fight because there is something to prove there. Have you ever heard of bragging rights? Now, as we gear up for this fight, as we talk about it, as we prepare for this fight, it is hard for most fans not to think about and remember Heather's last outing against Christina Williams, a fight that left her looking like this. Woo! Remember I told you, blood and guts warrior. But one thing I would say about Heather, if you're a person, if you're a fan of Heather Hardy and you're worried how this loss is going to affect her, look at her track record. I know you're not looking at losses with her, but look at her track record as a warrior. Check her out on Instagram right after the loss, from then all the way up to now. This woman has been nothing but positive, looking like she's working twice as hard. She is a warrior, and I'm sure that loss will not have an effect on her as she enters this fight with Ana. If it does have an effect on her, it will have a positive effect on her. Now, what is super interesting about this fight is Heather and Ana are gonna actually fight two fights. They're gonna fight one in the cage and one in the boxing ring. And I wish we could actually see more of this. Maybe with Dana White venturing over into boxing, we will see a little more of this. I think it's cool. Now, I know a lot of fans were hoping to see this at the highest level with Floyd Mayweather and Conor McGregor. Fans thought that maybe after the boxing match, Floyd Mayweather could be talked into, paid into, bribed into, climbing into a cage at 40 years old to take on Conor in an MMA bout. Now, I'll say this, it's nothing wrong with wishful thinking, but if you really thought about it, if you really put the thinky think on and use common sense, everybody should have known there was no way that Floyd Mayweather, at 40 years old, was going to climb into a cage and allow Conor McGregor to grab him in the headlock, kick him in the shins, and kick him in the ear. But we do have it with Heather and Ana, and I'll say this going in. My first look at it going in is Heather should be favored in the ring, Ana should be favored in the octagon. Now, that is not at all to say that Ana won't win in the ring and Heather won't win in the octagon. I'm just saying, if you had to put down early favorites, I would look to go that way. And let me tell you why. In the octagon, Ana's been doing it longer. Plus, if you look at Ana's fight game in the octagon, I would say she's better from the waist down. And that's not just the kicks. Of course, she has better kicks than Heather. Heather is really still trying to learn. We saw it in the Christina Williams fight. She's trying to get comfortable enough with her kicks where they can actually become a weapon for her during the fight. Ana's already at that stage. Her kicks are already a weapon for her. But even further than the kicks, Ana's movement and her stance is a lot more like MMA movement and the MMA stance that you hold in the octagon. A lot of people don't know. A lot of people think that boxing and MMA are so similar. The only similarities is that you get to punch. That is similar. But it pretty much stops there. Again, let's go back to Conor McGregor versus Floyd Mayweather. Remember Conor McGregor, even when he would land shots on Floyd Mayweather, it seemed like he couldn't get a lot of crack on it. And when you see Conor punching people in the octagon, think Eddie Alvarez. He was dropping people. He was hurting people. That's because he was in a stance that was set for the octagon, set for the MMA. A lot of times MMA fighters stand on a lot wider base. Their legs are a lot further apart because they're gonna throw kicks. They're also thinking about checking kicks, blocking kicks. There's a lot more to think about with your legs in an MMA stance. When you get into the boxing stance, you bring your legs a little closer together. You're a little bit more bouncy on your feet. If you look at Heather Hardy inside the MMA cage, she is pretty much still in a boxing stance. In the Christina Williams fight, the kick that pretty much ended the fight, the kick that broke her nose and made her nose explode. If you watch Heather, she actually starts into a boxing move. Christina starts at her. Heather drops down, getting ready to throw the check left hook. That is something else we broke down in that video. So after you watch this, go look at that video in the description box. We have a great breakdown of that moment there. Now, I fully expect Heather to be improved from her last fight with Christina Williams. That's just the type of fighter Heather is. You know she's been working hard. It's been all over Instagram, working on BJJ. Heather will be better, but these things take time. You can't learn this stuff over the course of just a few months. So at the end of the day, I feel Ana is a little more advanced in the octagon. When they flip over to the boxing ring, I would give Heather the advantage there. I think she's the fresher boxer. I think she has better legs there. I give Heather the advantage in the boxing ring. But I'll tell you one thing for sure, I am excited about both of these matches, the MMA and the boxing match. And guess what? I wouldn't be surprised if I'm wrong about both of them. That's just how scrappy both these ladies are. Expect two good fights. Now is my favorite part of every episode. You get in the comment section, tell me what you think. Tell me what you think of Ana. Tell me what you think of Heather. Tell me what you think of Heather's return. I love to to hear you guys' thoughts. It is great to hear what you guys are thinking, you guys' viewpoints. So make sure you get into the comment section. Let me know what you think. Okay, until the next one, it's your boy, Big E, aka Emazing Eric with Emazing Eric Sports. I'm out of here, y'all. Peace.